I don't even know what I was trying to do there. But it is Christmas Eve, and, well, we have a lot to talk about. It's been a few days. It's been a few days since we found out, you know, what the bowls were going to be, and some of them have already been played and stuff like that. It was even one day. Again, congratulations to those teams that have already won their bowl game. But we have a bowl Saturday, finally, for the first time. Even though there's only going to be two of them this year instead of the usual, you know, three. That's okay. That's perfectly fine. But this first bowl Saturday really has a couple of things lined up. Both of the teams that were slated to meet in the Sun Belt Championship game are going to have some damn good matchups, and I'm going to watch them both. First Responders Bowl, UTSA, who has been very good this year. We're talking really good. I mean, just completely under the radar good. And they'll be taking on Louisiana. Again, First Responders Bowl, that's 2:30 p.m., 3:30 Eastern on the big ABC, the mothership. You know, it's not ESPN, thankfully. Thank God for that. And then the team that was named Sun Belt Champions by the CFP committee, I don't know why the Sun Belt decided, again, don't know why the Sun Belt decided to name Coastal Carolina, those damn Chanticleers, who are undefeated. You know, they're a damn good team, and they'll be taking on Liberty. This was supposed to happen, you know, a couple weeks back, but it didn't. And we got the best game of the season in Mormons versus Mullets. I hope that game is going to happen for a long while. That is, you know, we got to get another matchup of that real soon. Speaking of BYU, they whooped up on UCF the other day. Crazy stuff right there. So that is really what's on tap for Bowl Saturday. I know there's a couple other games on that Saturday as well, but I mean, they're not really for me. But, you know, some games have been canceled. Some games are looking like, you know, hey, this game might not happen. I know Iowa's having some COVID issues, and South Carolina had COVID issues. So I don't know where in the world UAB is going to go. They could be left out. The poor CUSA champs could be left out of that game. You'd be left out of a bowl. The other big ones that, you know, we talk about, my Longhorns will be going up against Colorado, the only other Pac-12 team to go to a bowl game, you know, and they are in the Alamo Bowl this time. We're going to have fun in the Alamo Bowl. You know, Colorado looked rough in that last game that they had against Utah. I'm talking real rough. And they just couldn't, you know, stop Utah. And if things go the same here, you know, I know all Texas fans have unrealistic expectations, including myself. But, you know, it's time to prove yourself. This is a great way to start next year off. You're already losing on the recruiting trail, that I know of, I think. I don't know where Texas is on the recruiting trail right now, but early signing day has started too, so I don't know what in the world's going on a recruiting trail, but we'll find out. We'll find out soon. But as long as, you know, my Longhorns beat Colorado, I'll be okay. And if not, it's just the norm for... It's just the norm for this team. It's just the norm. And New Year's Day, and January the 2nd as well. To kick off 2021... We have the Outback Bowl, the Citrus Bowl, and the Outback, the Citrus, and the Gator Bowl. Gator Bowl has the number 23 ranked team, the NC State Wolfpack, who have, you know, I'm very surprised they're ranked number 23. I mean, they have three losses, but I mean, it's been like they've been completely under the radar. But their best win might be Liberty, but they've been completely under the radar this year, and they've been doing a pretty good job this year, and they'll be taking on Kentucky in the Gator Bowl. Kentucky is, what, 4-6? Not a good record, but I mean, hey, that's the downside of going to a 10-game schedule this year. So, none of those Padre win type stats in this year in the SEC. So, you know, 4-6 Kentucky, you know, it's okay. It's perfectly fine. Ole Miss will be taking on Indiana in the Outback Bowl. That is on the is that on the first or the second? I think that's on the second. But the Outback Bowl, you know, Ole Miss is 4-5. Lane Kiffin is leading them out there. Again, you know, the records don't really matter this year. They haven't mattered this year, so whatever game was going to happen was going to happen. As far as this goes, you know, Indiana has to not look ahead and be like, oh, well, this, let's just go in the next year. You know, it doesn't even matter. You have to win this game in order to get some momentum going into next year. If you want to be the contenders that you say you are, then you have to beat up Ole Miss. You have to. Third on the docket and the last of the bowls on that, it'll be the first bowl game to kick off on January. The most traditional Citrus Bowl with Auburn taking on the 14th ranked Northwestern Wildcats, runners up in the Big Ten, lost the Big Ten championship, Peyton Ramsey company, and now we know who Auburn's new head coach is, Brian Harsin. So it's going to be pretty interesting to see how Auburn adjusts knowing this now. That was completely out of my radar with him being hired. But, you know, it happened. It happened. We just got to deal with it. You just got to deal with it. But, yeah, Auburn doesn't have Gus Malzahn anymore. Bringing in a new guy who has really no ties to the South. All of his ties are to Boise and stuff like that. I know he's been out and about in the South, you know, a couple times with Arkansas State and stuff like that. But Brian Harsin, that's really the big thing looming over Auburn's head. Northwestern just has to, you know, keep the momentum going. You know, they had it against Ohio State and they pretty much blew it away. But you can't let that get you down. You gotta pick yourself up, get back on the winning track. So, there you have it. New Year's Bowl, the New Year's Six, I will preview those. I will only recap the New Year's Six. That is all. Maybe I'll probably recap, you know, the other New Year's Day and January 2nd bowls too. But for the most part, New Year's Day, that's going to be what I focus on. And of course, whatever my Longhorns do, I'll make a video immediately after the Alamo Bowl ends. And, you know, that will be fun. Might make a video at the Orange Bowl ends too, but New Year's and January the 2nd, I'm definitely making videos on those days, so be on the lookout for that, and I'll see you guys in a few days to talk about the New Year's 6. Y'all take care.